Hey, what's up guys, this is Nayashek from blogdude.com, and in this video I'm going to show you how to create a super awesome parallax website using WordPress. So let's first see the demo website which we'll be creating in this video. Okay guys, so this is the website which we'll be creating in this tutorial. This is an amazing, super responsive, super awesome WordPress website. So let's see how it looks like. As you can see, when we scroll down we have different sections. In the first section we have a parallax image in the background, and at the top we have some content, as you can see a button and some text. And again when we scroll down, as you can see, this is also a parallax section, and as you can see this image is there in the above section but it also touches the bottom section, and this really looks cool. Then when we scroll down we have another section with some content on top, and at the background we have a beautiful image. There are many pre-made images like this available with the theme. And then again we have a parallax section, and at the left sidebar we have some text, at the right sidebar we have some icons with some text, some title. Then again we have similar kind of section. Now as you can see, this is a gallery section, and this is really beautiful, really awesome. There is no gutter, there is no gap between these gallery, it is full width, and this really looks cool. And here we have some services, as you can see, professional blogging, and so you can create everything like this. And at the bottom, as you can see, we have this section, again a parallax section with some text on it. And at last we have another section where we have some different icons with, you know, status, the address, phone number, email address, and this kind of stuff. And at the bottom we have the footer, as you can see. When we click on this button we are sent back to the top of the page, as you can see. Now let's see the about us page which we are going to create in this video. So just click on about us. I have given a link in the video description below where you can see the demo website, and you can also check out by yourself this website, and I hope you guys really like this website. So as you can see at the about section at the top we have a banner, and it is written about us, get to know us better. You can change any text obviously. Then when you scroll down we have another section with three different columns and a title and a paragraph. Then again different sections. Then we have three portfolios. Then we have another section with background color is blue, and we have some progress bar, as you can see. So this was our about us page. It is really nice, clean and professional. Now let's see the blog page, because nowadays every website has a different blog section, so we also have created a different blog section. So let's see this. Okay, so this is the blog section. As you can see, this is how your blog page looks like. Now let me show you how a single blog looks like, a single post looks like. So just open this post in a new tab. Oh yeah, so this is our post. This is really cool, really beautiful. This is a blog quote. Then some paragraph, then there is a drop cap. I'll show you how to do all these things, how to put this block code, how to insert the drop cap, how to insert these different icons in a post, and how to put these social links. So this was our blog page. As you can see at the bottom we have a comment section, and just above that we have related post section. So this was our single blog page. Now let's close this. Now let's move on to the contact us page. We have created a very professional contact us page. At the top there is a map, and there is also a marker. When we click on this marker the address pops up. Then when we scroll down again we have different buttons, different icons with different information, very useful for contact page. Then at the bottom we have a contact form which can be filled by the user. We also created a special page, services page, so let's have a look at that. Okay, so this page is also very beautiful. As you can see there are different sections, very beautiful section, for example this portfolio section. Then we have a parallax background, and on top of that we have, you know, colorful icons with different services like client support, individual approach. Then at the bottom again we have, you know, different columns with different colors, and you can put anything in this. You can put your own title, your own paragraph, you can put different icons in different tabs. Okay guys, so this is the website which we'll be creating in this tutorial, and I hope you guys like this theme because this is really amazing. It's really cool, really awesome. It is mobile friendly. Let me show you. Hey guys, so as you can see, when we switch on to the mobile section, this is how your website looks like in a mobile device. Your menu shifts here. When you click on this, your menu pops up. You can close this and everything is auto adjusted. You don't have to scroll left and right to go to different section. Everything is automatically adjusted and this is really beautiful. As you can see, all the thing is automatically adjusted. Really looks beautiful. You also have this icon in the mobile version. So this is really helpful and it gives a look of web page. It looks like web app. So this is also very useful. Okay guys, so let's start creating this website. To create any kind of website, whether it be e-commerce website, business website, portfolio website, social network website, we need a hosting account. So for a hosting account, I prefer HostGator. So what you can do is in the URL bar, just type in blogdude.com/HostGator. As you can see, blogdude.com/HostGator and press enter. When you do so, you will be redirected to this particular page. Here we have three different plans. I prefer the baby plan, so click on sign up now. Okay guys, now we have to fill in this order form. At the top we have a domain name box, so you can put in any domain name you want. If you already have a domain name, click on here. So I already have a domain name, I will click here and put in my domain name. Okay, next we have a hosting plan. We have to choose a hosting plan. We have already selected a baby plan. Now we have to select the billing cycle. I go with 12 month because that is really easy. Now you can choose any username you want and any security pin. It can be any number. Fine. Now here put in all your information like your email address, first name, last name, your address, zip code, city. And here put in the details of your credit card or debit card through which you want to make payment. You can also pay with PayPal, so it's all up to you. Now scroll down, we have some additional services. We don't want any additional services, so just untick all those which are already ticked. Then the fifth section is a coupon code section. Now what you have to do, just delete everything which is there inside and type in webdude45 and click on validate. Okay guys, so by doing so, you get some additional discount on this package. So make sure you use this code webdude45. Now at the bottom, you'll see this, just tick mark. I have read and agreed to the terms and services and click on checkout now. When you click on checkout now, you'll receive an email from HostGator. So let's open and see how that email looks like and what it has. Okay guys, so this is how your email should look like. This is very important email because it has all the important information like your username, domain, password, name servers. So what you have to do is just save this information somewhere so that you don't miss out anything. And here you have a control panel link. Open this link in a new tab. And now copy and paste your username and your password from here and click on login. Okay guys, so this is the HostGator cPanel. This is really useful. It has many different informations, different options, but now we have to select this option, WordPress one click installation. So just click on this. Now from here, select your domain name and make sure the directory thing is empty. Don't put anything over here. Okay, fine. Now click on next. Now you can put in any blog title. For example, I am putting Parallax website. You can put any admin username. Now put in your first name and your last name and your email address. Fine. Now tick mark over here, terms of service agreement, and now click on install now. Okay guys, so our installation is completed. So let's open this link in a new tab. It says website coming soon. So what you have to do, again click on over here in the URL bar, and after your website URL, type in // wp-admin and press enter. Now again copy your username and password from here and paste it over here. After that, click on login. Okay guys, so this is our WordPress cPanel, WordPress dashboard. The first thing what we have to do is change the password, because as you can see, we got a very different kind of password from HostGator. We want our own password. So hover over here and click on edit my profile. Now scroll down. Here you'll see something called generate password. So click on that. Now we don't want these kind of password, we want our own custom password. So delete this and type in your own password. Fine, it says it is very weak, I want to use this password only. So click on over here, confirm use of weak password, and click on update profile. Fine, now it says your website is displaying a coming soon page. Once you are ready to launch your site, click here. So just click here. So our website is launched successfully. Now delete all these things, cut all these things, all these messages. So now we have successfully installed the WordPress on our website. The next step is to install the theme on the website. So let's first see how our website looks like now. When you hover here, you'll see the visit site title. Now open this link in a new tab. Okay guys, at present this is how our website looks like, and this is not that good website. We want to create something amazing and something awesome like this. So for that we need to install a theme. There are many themes available in the market, but I have selected the best theme for Parallax website. So you'll see a link in the video description below. Just click on that link and you will be redirected to the theme page. Or else what you can do is open a new tab and type in blogdude.com/monstroid, and you'll be redirected to that particular page through the template or the theme page. Okay guys, so this is the theme which we'll be using in our tutorial. This is the Monstroid WordPress theme. It has been rated 5 star by 195 people. So we want the single site license, so make sure single site license is selected. And just don't worry about the theme, because this is the best selling WordPress theme on Template Monster. Click on add to cart and select your mode of transport by which you want to pay. For example, PayPal, card, Stripe, Skrill, WebMoney, whatever you want to use. I have already purchased this theme, so I won't be purchasing this theme again. After you purchase this theme, you will receive an email from Template Monster. This would look something like this. Now let's open this email. This email is really useful. It has your license key and many information. So what you have to do is click on proceed to download. Here you have many important information like your license key, your theme download link. So what you have to do, just click on this button and your theme will start downloading. I have already downloaded the theme, so I won't be downloading it again. Okay guys, so once you have downloaded the theme, next what you have to do, here you see something called Monstroid Wizard plugin. Now click on this and also download this plugin. This is very important plugin. So make sure you download both the theme and this plugin, because this is the plugin which will get us started. This is how your files would look like. This is the theme file and this is the plugin file. Now what we have to do is come back to our dashboard, and now come back to your dashboard, and as you can see here we have many different options, and here at the left side we have something called plugins. So hover over plugins and select add new. Now click on upload plugin. Now choose the file. Now choose this file, Monstroid Wizard, and click on open. Now click on install. Now click on activate plugin. After activating the plugin, come back over here, hover over tools, and when you hover tools you will see an option called Monstroid Wizard. Just click on that. Now here you have to put in the activation key. So again, go back to your mail which you received and copy the license key and paste it over here and click on start. Now after doing so, you will receive two options: install Monstroid main theme, and the second option is install one of the child themes. So what you have to do is install the Monstroid main theme. So click on over here, install. Now everything will start installing itself. Okay guys, so once everything is installed and activated, you'll see something like this. So what you have to do is just click on this, skip this step. It says congratulations, you have successfully installed your new theme with sample data. So now what you have to do, just open this link in a new tab. Okay, now as you can see, our website looks a bit different than it used to look before some time. As you can see, there are some differences between both the website. And this looks much better than before, but still this is not the website which we want to create. We want to create something amazing like this. So let's do that. Come back to your dashboard. Here you see something called pages, hover pages, and click on add new. Now enter the title of the page. So we have to put home page. Now we are starting to create the home page. This is the home page. So once you do that, click on publish over here. Okay guys, so here you see something called MotoPress container editor. Just click on this. Okay guys, so this is the MotoPress editor. So now let's start creating our website. As you can see, the first section we have some text and a button with the parallax image in the background. So let's start doing that. However, here you'll see different options. So from here, select paragraph and drag it over here. Fine, so as you can see, this is dragged over here. Now just copy this text from here and paste it over here. You can type in your own text, obviously. Okay, so we have the text right now. Now as you can see, there is some gap between the text and the button. So now let's do that and put some space between the text and the button. So for that, you'll see something box over here. So however, this box, and you'll see something called spacer. As you can see, here is the spacer. Now drag this spacer below this paragraph. And in the size option, put in 30. And rest everything will be fine. So just cut this thing. So now we have this paragraph, we have some space. Now we have to add this button. So again, here is the button section. So however, here you'll see this button option. Now drag this button below the spacer. Fine. Now you can change the text of the button. Here our button says take a tour. So we'll also type take a tour over here. Fine. You can put in the link wherever you want to redirect this button to. In the style, put in danger. Here is the danger style. Select this. The size of the button will be large. Displays inline, that is fine. Centered, no, fine. And fluid will be yes. And now we have to select the fluid position. Here, as you can see, it is on the right side. So we'll also select the right side. So click on here and select right. Fine, now cancel this. So we have the text, we have the button. Now we have to add this image, the parallax image. So what we have to do, come back over here and we hover here. When we hover here, we see these three dots over here. As you can see, when if you see my cursor, there is three dots over here. So this is the row option. Select this dot. And as you can see, now we are getting the row option. So in the width type, select fixed width. And in the background type, it will be parallax image because we want to add a parallax image in the background. Now we have to select the background image. Fine, so click on here. If you have some image already in your media library, you can upload it from here. But if you don't have, you can upload your own image right from here. Now from here, you can upload any image you want for the parallax background. I have selected this image. I already have this image. So what I'll do, I'll upload this image. So when you see, in the video description below, you have a link which will redirect you to this page. Here you have all the images which I have used in my website. So you can download those images from here also. I already have those on my desktop. So what I'll do is click on over here, select files. And select the images you have. And this is the image which we have used. So select this image and click on open. Now click on set media. Fine. Now cancel this. And we have some gap, as you can see, both above and below this content. So now let's do that. Let's add some padding or some gap below and above this content. So again, come back over here. Click on these three dots, the row setting, and here you have style option. So click on style and click over here. So you already get many options over here. So from here, select padding top 160 pixel and scroll down, you'll see more options. So from there, select padding bottom 140 pixels. Fine. Now cancel this. Okay, so we are done with the first section, the parallax image section. We are not seeing the image over here, but when we preview this page, let's click on preview. So as you can see, we have the image over here, but our button is going outside the image, and also the color is black. We want white color like we have in the website. So let's do that. Actually, this thing is going out of this first row. So what we have to do is select this, drag over here. When you drag over here, you'll see an option called insert, as you can see in the screen. So leave your cursor. Now we have inserted this in our first row. Fine. Now we have inserted this in our first row. Now when we click over here in these three dots, we'll see row inner. So this has become the inner of this row. And when we click on over here, this is the main row. Fine. And this has become the inner row. Now we have to put some gap between this thing, the paragraph and the button. So let's put some gap. However, here you'll see spacer. Now drag that spacer over here. Fine. And put the size 30. Fine. Now we have some space between the paragraph and the button. Now we have to change the color of the text. So just double click over here. Now select everything, and here you have text color. Select this, and from here select white color. Once you do so, click on preview. Now we can see the color of the text has changed. Also, our button is inside the main row. So we have done the first row. Now what we have to do is do the second row, this one. So let's do that. Again, come back over here. So before that, before changing those things, click on update so that we don't miss anything which we have already saved and done. Once you do so, just reload this page and now click on MotorPress content editor. Okay, now in the editor also we can see all the changes. Fine. Now we have to insert the next row like this one. So let's do that. Come back to your MotorPress, and again this is a image. So what we have to do is insert this image. So however, text, and from here select WordPress text and drag it over here. Fine. This thing will pop up. From here select add media, and again you can upload the image which you want to add. Now what I am doing is selecting all this image and uploading it at the same time so that I don't have to upload all the images one by one. Fine. Now after you select all these images, click on open. Now everything is getting uploaded. Okay guys, so once all the images are selected or uploaded, you'll see something like this. So now what you have to do is select the image which you want to upload. Now deselect all rest of the images. Fine. And make sure only one image, the main image, is selected which you want to insert. And after one image is selected, click on insert into page. Fine. Now select this image. You'll see this pencil option over here, edit option. Click on that and make sure this size is full. Here is the option full size, and click on update. Now click on save. Okay, so we have our image over here. As you can see in the demo website, we have some text and button beside the image. So let's do that. Come back to MotorPress. Now at the top here, we have some title. So now we have to add some title. So again, however, here on T, you'll see something called title box. Drag this till you see something column over here. As you can see beside the image, you'll see some blue section which says column. So when you get some option like that, leave your mouse, leave that button. So when you see that option, there is where you have to, you know, put your text, your title box. Now in the title, put in this thing or anything you want. And this is the subtitle. Okay, I'm just copying and pasting to save our time. Now scroll down and you can select the color of this different title and subtitle. As you can see, here is different color, so you can select different color from here for title and for subtitle. Now alignment, you can select the alignment left or right, and from here you have to select subtitle first, so it will be subtitle then title. And now you can select the size of the title. So here the larger size is selected. We want some smaller size, so select this and select the style to smaller. Fine. Now cancel this. Now we have to add some gap between both this paragraph and the title. So now let's hover over here, drag this spacer over here. Fine. Now we have to put some space. So we have some space between the title. Now we have to put a paragraph. So again, hover over T, you will see something called paragraph. Just drag that over here. And now just copy and paste the text from here. Now we have to add this button. So let's do that. Again, hover here, select this button, drag till here. You can change the text, fine. The style, there are different styles, so we are selecting the danger style. Style basically changes the color of the button. Fine. The size is too big, we'll select the small size, and rest everything will be fine. But there's no gap between the paragraph and the button, so let's do that. Again, add a spacer between both this thing. Okay, 20 pixel will be fine. So now we have some space between the paragraph and the button. And again, after the button, we have to add some space. So again, drag this spacer over here. And in the size, put in 40. Now cancel this. Fine. When you see the demo website, there is a gap between the first section and the second section. Also, there is a gap between the second section and the third section. Okay, so let's do that. Let's add some gap over here at the top. So add a spacer at the top. Fine. And in the size, put in 75. In the tablet section, put in 45. And in the mobile section, put in 30. Now cancel this. Now below this section also, we have to add some space. So again, put a spacer over here. And in the size, put in 40. Rest everything will be fine. Now cut this thing. Now let's preview the page. Hey guys, as you can see, now we can successfully see the changes over here. Now let's see how it looks in a mobile phone. Now let's scroll down. As you can see, when we see in mobile, we see two different columns, but we don't want this kind of thing. It is really confusing. Let's see the demo website. As you can see, when we see the demo website, we are getting a perfect look. The image is at the top and the content is at the bottom. So we want something like this. But in our website, as you can see, this thing are getting messed up. So let's maximize this and let's solve this problem. So again, come back to your MotoPress, and here when we hover over this image, you'll see three dots at the top. That is the column option. Select that option, and in the first column, put in 12, in the second, put in 6, and in the third one, put in 5. These are basically the sizes in extra small devices, in small devices, in large devices. Fine. Now here you see offset large device. Here put in 1. Now cancel this. Now select this one and click on here. You should see this column option at the top. The title should be column. Again, Now here also we have to make some change. The first thing, for small, extra small devices, the size should be 12. For small devices it should be 6, and for large it should be 4. So put in these settings, cancel this. Now again let's preview the page. Click over here. Now again let's see how it looks in a mobile phone. Let's minimize this and scroll down. And now as you can see, this now looks awesome. Everything is fine. Now the image is at the top and the content is at the bottom. So column setting is really important, as you can see. Now let's add the third column, the third section. So come back to the MotoPress. And as you can see over here in the third section, we have an image at the left side. So let's first add the image at the left side. Now again hover over this T and select WordPress text and drag it over here. Fine till you see something called a row. So we have to insert a new row. And again we have to add a media. So click on add and select the media. So this is the image we want to add, the mobile image. Select this and click on insert into page. Now again click on this and edit this page or edit this photo, and in the size it should be full size. And in the advanced option, click on advanced option, you'll see something called image CSS class. Under that type in custom dash image dash phone. Fine. Now click on update. Now click on save. Now cancel this. So we have done the left thing, the left side there is an image, at the right side there is some text, so let's put that. Now let's put this paragraph and drag it over here till you see this column option. Now let's copy and paste everything from here. Fine. So we have this also, we have the image and we also have this text over here. And here as you can see, the image section is quite smaller and the text section is quite bigger. So let's resize this. So when you hover over here, you'll see this option, the icon with two rows. So just click and drag this image a bit over here at the left side. Fine, this looks fine right now. Now we have to add some space below this section, below this paragraph. So select the spacer, drag it over here and put in 60 or 40, whatever you like. Let's try 60 and cancel this. Fine. And again we have to do column settings so that we want our columns in mobile phones up and down, not side by side. That doesn't look good. So select the first column, as you can see over here, you'll see three dots, click on that, you'll see the column option from here. And put in 12, 12 and 5, fine. Now however this, again select these three dots over here, you'll see the column option again. And here put in 12, 12 and 7. So 12 for extra small devices, 12 for small devices and 7 for large devices. Now cut this thing. Now let's add the spacer. Okay, over here. Okay, fine. So now let's preview this page. Let's scroll down. Okay, as you can see, the image looks fine. So this looks cool, but here as you can see we have a parallax image in the background, so let's do that. So when we hover here, you see this option, the row option, you'll see this row option. The width type should be full width, background type will be parallax image because we want a parallax image in the background. Now from here select the parallax image you want. So this is the image we want in the parallax. Now click on set media. You can set the parallax speed 2 or 1.5, whatever you like it. Fine. Now we can also change this style if you want some padding to the top or bottom. So we want some padding at the top, so select padding top 140 pixel and cut this thing. Now again, let's preview the page and see the changes. Okay guys, so as you can see, there is some problem because we have made the changes in this row, which is spacer. We have made the changes to the spacer. We want to make the changes in this particular row so that we see the parallax image behind this row, not in the spacer. Fine. So what we do is, again, in the spacer row here, this is the spacer, click here, and in the styles, just delete this. So okay, we have deleted this, and in this setting also, find, make everything as none, background type is none, and everything will be fine. Now we have to make changes in this particular row, so click over here. Okay, when you click on this row settings, you should see this whole thing in one single box. As you can see, a very thin border outside everything, so this says that everything over here is under one single row. Fine. So on clicking this, you should see a thin border outside the image and the paragraph. If you can see that, you're going right. Fine. Now let's maximize this, and here we have to do those changes. Full width, background type will be parallax image. Now select the background image, this is the one, click on set media, and style will be 140 pixels top. Fine. Now let's cut this, and now again see the preview, and this time everything should be fine. Let's scroll down, and as you can see, now it is looking fine. The parallax image is behind this, not in the spacer section. So we have done the third section also. We have completed three sections. Now let's go on to the fourth section. This is the fourth section, as you can see. Now let's put this thing. As you can see, in the fourth section, there is a title, a paragraph, and a button. So let's add that. Come back to your motor press, and hover over T, you'll see title box. Just drag that over here. Fine. Now we have to put in the title and subtitle. I'll just copy from here the title, and this is the subtitle. Fine. Now we have to select the title color and the subtitle color. As you can see over here, the title and the subtitle color is white, so we have to select that. Click over here. Fine. And drag this to the top till you see something called, you know, hashtag, and then 6 times F, small F. So this is the code, hex code for color. Now you can copy this and paste in the subtitle color also. So we have done the title color and subtitle color as white. Fine. You can change the alignment, and in this style we want the subtitle first, and the title size also should be smaller. So select this. Fine. We cannot see the changes as over here because we have made the color of the title as white and our background is also white. So let's change the background so that we can see the changes over here. So select over here this three dots, you'll see the row changes. Fine. Now in the width type, select fixed width, background type select color slash image, and scroll down. In the styling present, select polygonal 3. Fine. Now again, you can change this settings if you want. Now come over here in the styling option, and we have to select padding top 60 pixels, and padding bottom also 60 pixels. Now cancel this, click on preview so that we can see the changes. Okay guys, so as you can see, the changes over here. Now again, come back and click on update because we cannot see the, you know, background image over here. So when we click on update and refresh the page, we'll see that. Now refresh the page. Now scroll down, and as you can see, now we can see the changes over here. So we have added the title. Now we want the paragraph. Okay, so hover T and select paragraph and drag it over here till you see something called insert. Now just copy this thing and paste it over here, or type in anything you want. Fine, so we have the title, we have the paragraph. Now we have some gap between the paragraph and the button, so let's add some space between this. So drag this spacer over here. Fine, and put in 40 for tablets also. We want 40 for mobile devices also, 40. So make sure everything is 40 over here. Now cancel this. Now we have to add a button. Fine, so however here, just drag this button over here. Now scroll down in the style, select warning. Fine, the size should be small and rest everything is fine. Okay, so cut this thing. Now we have a similar kind of column in the second also. So what we can do is just click on this title, and here we have a duplicate option. Let's minimize this. Now here we have the duplicate option, just click on this. So as you can see, the title is duplicated over here. So similarly, let's duplicate the paragraph also. Now let's click on this spacer, click on duplicate. Now again, click on this button, and from here, click on duplicate. Fine, so we have duplicated all this data, all this content. Now let's add some space on top of both these columns. So select spacer from here and maximize this. Select 40 and cut this thing. Now again, duplicate this thing. So we have two different spaces on top of both the columns. Now let's change the column setting. Now click on these three dots over here. Fine, you should see column over here. Now in the extra small size, it will be 12, and small size it will be 12, and rest everything will be fine. Now cancel this. Now select this, hover this, and you will see these three dots. Click on that. The column setting will pop up. Again, put in 12, again 12, and don't do anything with the rest option. Just cancel this. Now let's click on preview and see the changes. Let's scroll down. Okay guys, so as you can see, this really looks beautiful. We have two different columns, and this image is coming on this different section. So this is also looking very fine. Okay, so we have completed the fourth section also. Now we have to add this fifth section. So let's do that. So again, come back to your MotoPress, and here we have a paragraph. So what we have to do is hover T and drag this paragraph over here. Fine, now let me just copy this thing from here and paste it over here. The color is white, so that that's why we are not able to see. When we select everything, we are able to see because the color is white. As you can see, when we copied, it was all white. When we'll put this parallax image in the background, we'll see the changes over there. Fine, so let's do that. When you hover here, you see three dots. Select that. Then we have the row options. It is full width, and background type should be parallax image. Now from here, we have to select the image. This is the image. Now click on select media. Rest everything is fine. Now click on style and top padding should be 160 pixels. Fine, now cancel this. Click on preview to see the changes. Okay, so we can see the changes. Now we have to, you know, adjust all these things. So again, come back to MotorPress, update this page and reload this page so that we can also see the changes over here also. Okay, so now let's scroll down, and as you can see, now we can see the changes over here. Now we have to put in this thing. So again, hover here and select WordPress text and drag it over here till you see the column at the side. Fine. Now we have to add this icon and this different text. For that, click on insert shortcode, select box. Here is the box. You can also search for box, then that thing will be highlighted. So from here, select box. The present style should be vertical aligned. Rest all, everything is fine. So just click on insert shortcode. Now here, as you can see, the text is your content goes here. Select that text and delete that. Now here we have to put in our content. So again, click on insert shortcode because we want to insert this icon right now, and search for icon. Here it is. Select this and here click on icon picker and search for copy. Here it is. This is the name of this icon. Fine. Now we have to set the icon size. Put it as 44. Alignment will be left. Now put in the icon color. You can put any color of your choice. I have already selected a color, so I'm putting that code. Okay, so once you select the icon color, here you have to select the background color. Now let's see, there is no background color, so we will leave this as blank. Now we have to select the border. As you can see, we have a very thin border over here, so let's do that. Here, put in 2 pixels solid and the color of the border. As you can see, the color of the border and the color of the icon is same, so make sure you put the same color setting over here also. Fine. Now the geometric type, it should be round because the icon over here is round. After you do all these things, click on insert shortcode. Fine, so we have our icon right now. Now we have to add this text, so I'll just copy and paste it over here. Fine. Now click on save. So as you can see, we can see the changes over here, but the color is different. The color of the text is different. So double click over here. Select this text, and here you have the toggle toolbar option. Just click on that. You'll see some additional options. We have the text color. Select that. Select custom and put the same color code which you have put for the icon and the text. Now click on OK. Now click on save. Cancel this. As you can see, now we are seeing something similar to this, but we have two more things over here. So again, come back over here, double click over here. Now before we put in these different icons, we can see there is a small gap between all these three. So let's put that below this cherry box. Press enter and click on insert shortcode and search for spacer. In the size, put in 30. Click on insert shortcode. So it will give some space between these two logos, these two icons. Now instead of repeating everything same, because we have to just change the icon, rest everything will be fine. What I'll do is just copy everything press and enter after the space and paste it 2 times. Fine. Now what I have to do is just change the icon. So from here, as you can see, the cherry icon option, every icon has a different code name. The icon which we earlier used was copy, and the name of this icon is gear. So I'll type gears. Fine. Then we have another icon. This is the download icon. Fine. So I'll put download over here. Now click on save. So as you can see, now we are seeing the changes over here. Fine. But there is no gap below this section. So let's change that setting. Click on the row setting over here. Select style. Okay, so we have only selected padding top. We also have to select the padding bottom. So from here, select padding bottom 140. Fine. Now cancel this again. Okay, now we can see some gap below this. Now click on preview to see the changes. Let's scroll down. Let's see how it looks in a mobile device. As you can see, we are getting 2 things over here, both for this one and for this one. So we have to do the column setting. Come back over here. Select this column option. And the first put in 12, then 4. And in the offset LG, put in 2. Fine. Now select the second column. Now again, the same number of over here. And over here, 12, 16, and 4. Now cut this. Now click on update and click on preview to see the changes now. Now let's minimize and see the changes. So as you can see, now we can see that this is on top and this thing is at the bottom. So let's maximize this. Fine. So we have done the 5th parallax also. Now we have to do this 6th one, the 6th section. So again, come back to MotorPress. And here we have some text over here. At the top, we have a title box, then a paragraph and a button. So let's do that. Hover here, select title box, drag it to the bottom. Now put in the title and your subtitle. I'll just copy and paste over here. Fine. You can select the color of the title and the subtitle from here. The alignment. The subtitle will be first, so select this one. And let the style be normal, for because in the demo website we can see the text is bigger, so we want bigger size over here. Now cancel this. Now we have to add this image. So come back over here, hover over this and select WordPress text and drag it over here till you see this column option. Now click on add media. Now select the file, select this one, click on insert into page. Select this image now, click on edit and make sure the size is full size. Click on update. Now click on save. Okay, so now we have 2 different columns. This is one column and this is another column. Now what we have to do, we have to add this paragraph and the button. So again, hover here, select paragraph, and we have to insert over here. Now just copy the paragraph, paste it over here. After that, we have some gap over here, as you can see. So let's put this gap. Select the spacer option. Fine. And the size should be 50 pixels. Cancel this. Then below this we have a button, so just drag this button option over here. You can change the text and everything. Style is danger. The size is small, fine. And rest everything looks fine. So cancel this. As I said earlier, you should see a thin border outside both the columns. So it means that both this thing are in the same row. Now select this option, row option. And in the style setting, put in padding top as 160 pixels and padding bottom 140 pixels, and cut this thing now. Now hover here and select this one, the main column, the first column, and put in 12, 6 and 4, and for the offset LG put in 2. Now cut this thing. Now select this second column, the image column. Fine. Now here also put in 12, 6 and 5. Rest everything will be fine. Now click on update and click on preview to see the changes. Now let's scroll down. And as you can see, now we have this option also. Behind this one, be the parallax image, we have this option also, just like in the demo website. Now we have to add this gallery, this beautiful gallery. Fine, so again come back to the MotoPress. Now first click on update so we don't miss any changes over here. And in the URL bar, just put in your website name slash wp-admin and press enter, because now we want to go to our dashboard. Now we have to create this design, because this design is not already present in the website, so I'll show you how to do that. When you come back to your dashboard, you will see an option called cherry over here. So what you have to do is just hover over cherry, you will see this option, shortcode templater, just click on that. And again go back to my website link, here you will see something called custom code file, just click on download. Once you do that, one new page will open up here. The first one is the shortcode template for chart, the second one is for post, fine. Then we have one for portfolio, then one for about us. So we'll be using all this code, you don't have to do anything, you just have to copy and paste this code. Now from here select this one, the code under the post one, here it is written create shortcode template under post. So just copy this much, come back to your dashboard and here you'll see post, click on that. Now click on add new. Now select everything over here, now delete this and paste in the code which we have copied from here and click on save. And here remember the name, the name is post1.tmpl, that is template. So we have created the design for this. This is the code for the design. So we can now make this kind of gallery. Okay. So before making the gallery, we now have to create some portfolios. So here you will see an option for portfolio. Hover that and click on add item. Now put in the title of the portfolio. For example, when you see in the demo website, when we hover this image, we see your business portfolio. This is the title. So you can put in your own title. Let's put in your business portfolio. Now here in this box, type in anything which you want to display over here. For example, when we hover this, we see this subtitle over here. So type in a small subtitle. And after that you have to insert a read more button, here you will see that, click on that, a more button will come up over here, and after that you can add more text if you want, it's all up to you. So let's paste some dummy text over here. Once you do so, from here select the image format, You can create some categories for the portfolios if you want. For example, let's say technology and click on add new category. Now scroll down, you'll see this featured image. The image you see over here is the featured image. So click on set featured image. Select any image as the featured image, click on set featured image. Fine. Rest everything is fine. Once you do so, just click on publish. So similarly, you can create as many portfolios as you want. Now I'll pause this video and create some portfolios so that we can insert it over here. And after I create all the portfolios, I'll resume this video. Okay guys, so as you can see, I have added many portfolios over here. So it's time to add these portfolios on our home page. Okay, as you can see, we are missing the portfolio option. And in the demo website, we have this section. So let's do that. Come back to your dashboard. Here you'll see something called pages, hover pages, and select all pages. This is the page we have just created. Now open this link, edit with MotoPress in a new tab. Now hover here and select posts and drag it to the bottom. Now post per page will be 8, and post type it won't be post, so cancel this and type in portfolio. So post type will be portfolio, taxonomy will be categories, that is fine. Okay, the thumbnail, the featured image size should not be thumbnail. Select this and put this as monstroid thumbnail 475 into 300. The content length should be 30 and change this size of the columns. Put it as 12, 6, 6, and 3. Fine. Now at the bottom you'll see this template. Now select the post one template which we have created and click on update over here. Cancel this. Now click on preview to see the changes. Now let's scroll down. Okay, as you can see guys, we can see this beautiful gallery over here. So we have done this gallery section also. Now let's do this services section. Again, come back to the MotoPress. First, let's add some space. As you can see, there's a lot of space over here. So let's add some space. Drag this space over here. And the size should be 80. Rest everything will be fine. Now again, hover here, drag this WordPress text over here. Now we have to insert a shortcode. So click on insert shortcode and search for box. Select this box. Now here it should be vertical align. The style should be vertical align. Background image position should be top left. Click on insert shortcode. Now here it is, here you can see your content goes here. Select that, click on delete, press enter to put this thing down. Now here we have to put in this icon like we did last time. So again click on insert shortcode and search for icon. Now click this. As you can see, we have a check icon, so click on icon picker and search for check. So this is the icon we have. Select that. Now we have to select the size of the icon. We want a smaller size, so put in 17. The alignment should be left. Now the color is fine. The type is geometric type, should be round. As you can see, we have a round. everything is fine. So click on insert shortcode. So we now have this icon over here. Now let's copy this thing and paste it over here. Fine. Now again, after this icon and the title, we can see there's a small gap over here between the paragraph and that icon. So let's put that space. After this cherry box, just press enter, click on insert shortcode, search for spacer, select this one, size should be 30, fine, click on insert shortcode, and after that, just copy this thing from here and paste it over here. And again, after this, copy this spacer and paste it over here, because after this also we have some space, as you can see over here. Fine. Now copy everything and click on save. So as you can see, this is the thing over here. We can see like we have over here, but here we have three different columns. Here we have only one column, so make sure you have selected this and click on duplicate. Close this. Again, click on duplicate. So now we also have three different columns. Fine. Now let's do some column settings. So click over here, the three dots column setting, maximize this and type in 12, 12 and 4. Cut this thing, select this one, this column. Here also the size should be 12, 12 and 4. Fine. Now the third column, 12, 12 and 4. Again cut this thing. Now over here select the row setting, as you can see, and instead of full width, put it as fixed width and click on update. Now let's preview this site. Okay guys, so as you can see, we have this option now. We can see this. Now let's add this column, as you can see, a parallax image and some content on top. So again, hover over T and select this paragraph, drag it over here. Now just put copy and paste over here. Fine. We cannot see it because the text is in white color, but when we select, we can see this text over here. Now what we have to do is drag this thing little inside. Fine. This looks fine. Now click over here, row setting. Maximize this. Full width. Background type should be parallax image because we want to add a parallax image in the background. Now select that image. This is the image we want. Click on set media. Fine. Now click on style. Select padding top 160. Okay. And bottom 140. Click on update. Now click on publish. Now let's preview this website. Okay guys, so as you can see, we can see the changes over here. We have a parallax image and we also have the content over here. So again, come back over here. We cannot see the background image, so let's click on update. Okay, once we refresh the page, we can see the background over here. Fine. Now select this first column and select this option, the column option, and put it as 12. 12 and 4, and here we have to put the offset also, offset LG, that is large devices as 2. Now cut this, click on update. Fine. Now we have to add this last and final section for our home page. So let's again come back to the MotorPress. Now drag this WordPress text over here. And click on insert shortcode. Now search for icon. And here we have the home icon. So what we'll do is click on icon picker, search for home. This is the icon we want. The icon size should be 35. Fine. Alignment will be left. You can select any icon color. Here the icon color is white, so we want white color. Here's the white color. Click on here. Fine. The border color is this color, little bit, but we want the border color also white. So select this, select the white color, and geometric type should be round. Fine. Now click on insert shortcode. Now press enter and come to the next line and type in cherry box, just something like this. Again, copy this thing, paste it over here, and just before the cherry box, put a forward slash, as you can see in the screen. Now from here, copy this thing and paste in the middle. Fine. And if you are not copying and pasting, if you are putting your own text, then make sure the address thing is heading 5. As you can see from here, you can select, and this address should be paragraph. From here, select paragraph. Okay, now click on save. So we cannot see the icon inside because that is white. So let's change the color of this row. So select this row. Fine, it should be full width. Background type should be color or image. Now style should be danger. Fine, rest everything is fine. Now both top and bottom padding should be 60. So select that. Fine. Now let's preview this page. Okay guys, so this is how it looks like right now. We are not able to see the border because I think there is some problem with the border color, because the border color is set to orange. So let's double click over here. What is the border color? Okay, here is the problem. The border color should be white. So just, this is the code for white, hashtag and 6 times F. So copy this and replace this one. Now again, click on save. We cannot see it, means it has changed to white. Now what we have to do is select this thing and click on duplicate. We want 4 things over here, so just close this, minimize this, again click on duplicate, close, again click on duplicate, close this. Now update this file and let's preview this in a new tab. And let's preview this. So as you can see, we have this option over here. Find the home and address, everything. Now how to change this? Because here we have different icons, different text. So again, come back over here. First, refresh the website so that we can see the background. Okay, now let's scroll down. Okay, now we can see the changes over here. Now let's select this thing and double click over here. Now what we have to do is change the icon. Here we have a phone icon. So after this, you can see over here icon. After FA dash, it is written home. So select that home, delete that, and type in phone. Fine, rest everything will be fine. And instead of address, we have to type in phones. So select address from here and paste phones, or type in phones. Now we have to type in these numbers. So instead of this address, now we have some numbers. Fine. Now after you do so, just click on save. And as you can see, the changes have taken place. Now select this one, double click over here. In the demo website, we have the email and address. So what you have to do is just come back over here And again select this home and type in envelope, because we have an envelope icon over there. And instead of address, type in email and just type in your own email address. Fine. Instead of this, paste in your own email address and click on save. Now this also has changed. Now we have to change the fourth column, so double click over there. Here we have a clock icon and the text is something different. So again, come back over here, select this home, and instead of home we want a clock icon, and instead of address, type in we are open, and just type in this timing, Monday to Friday, whatever it is, and again click on save. Okay, we cannot see the clock icon because maybe there is some problem with that name. So put in clock dash O. Now click on update and click on preview to see the changes. Okay guys, so as you can see, we have successfully made our homepage with this. So our homepage is complete. Now what we have to do is create the blog page. So let's create this blog post and different blogs. So again, come back to your dashboard and under pages, click on add new. Add a new page called blog. Click on publish. Now we have to create different posts, that is different blogs. So hover over here, over post, and select add new. So this is the title of the post. So just copy and paste it over here. After that, we have some text, so you just have to type this text. So I'm not gonna type this long text, I'm just gonna copy and paste it over here. After that, we have this block code, so let's type in anything over here. For example, just type in anything over here. For example, I have typed in this thing, select this. And here you'll see the option called block code. So enter that. So this thing is block coded now. But as you can see, the size of this font is also bigger and the color is also different. So what you have to do is make this, select this line, and instead of paragraph, select heading 4 and select italic. And here select the text color, anything you want. For example, this one. Fine. Then after that, we have a name, so you can just copy and paste that name over here. Fine. Now after that, we have some simple text, so that is just copy and paste, because this is simple text, it is paragraph text, nothing more than that. Then after that, we have a drop cap. So first let's copy this simple text, and after that we'll put this drop cap. Fine. After pasting, click over here and click on insert shortcode and search for drop cap. So this is the drop cap. The font size should be 50, canvas size should be 68. You can select any background color, this looks better. Fine. The text color should be white. As you can see, the background color is something like blue and the text color is white over here. Okay. The alignment will be left. Now you can select the radius. Select the radius as 68 because our canvas size is also 68. And we don't want any border, so 0. And in the content, type in A. For example, because here we have the A as the drop cap. Fine. Now click on insert shortcode. Here, as you can see, everything is done right now. Fine. Now we have to insert this small icons, but before that, let's copy this thing, paste it over here. And before this, we have the icon. So click over here, click on insert shortcode and select icon from here.
Now in the icon picker, type in any icon you want. For example, here we have a paintbrush, so just type in paint and here it will show up paintbrush. Now the size is quite smaller, so put in 17. Alignment should be left. Color anything of your choice. Here we have something like blue color, so let's select a blue color from here. Fine. We don't want any background color, we don't want any border, so put 0. After that, click on insert shortcode. Fine. And this we want to make it as H6 because this is a bit bigger text than this one. So select this text and select H6 from here. Now again copy everything from here and paste it, again paste it, again paste it 4 times because we have 4 different icons over here, and you just have to change the icons as we did earlier. For example, here it is paintbrush. Now for the second one, just delete the paintbrush and type in gears. We have gears icon, so just type in gears. And similarly, you can do this for all the others. Okay, then after that we have just simple text, so just copy this one, paste it over here, and rest everything is fine. Okay, now in the format section, select image. Okay, and you can create any category from here also, or if you have already created, then you can select some categories from here. We haven't created, so let's create one category, technology, and click on add new category. Now put in a featured image for this blog. You can put any featured image. Fine, now click on publish. Now let's see how our post looks like. So just open this in a new tab. So we have successfully created, but it looks a bit different. As you can see, in the demo website we have a sidebar, but here we don't have a sidebar, and also there are some changes. It is all, you know, full width and this is a fixed width. So let's do those changes again. Come back to this page, the post page, scroll down, and in the content option select the boxed one. Fine. And in layout select left sidebar, and again click on update. Now let's refresh this post and see the changes. Okay guys, so as you can see, we can now see the changes. Everything is fine right now. Now after this, you can create as many posts as you want. I have to create some post because, you know, I have to, you know, show you guys how to create a blog page, and to create a blog page we need some blog first. So we have created one blog. Now I'll pause this video again and create some more blogs, and then after that I'll continue with the video. Okay guys, so as you can see, I have created a different post. Now what we have to do is put in all these posts into our blog page. So let's do that. Click on pages over here, and we have already created a blog page, so click on edit with MotorPress. As you can see, in the demo website we have a title at the top, so just copy this thing over here, and here put in a paragraph. Now paste this thing. Fine. After that we have some gap over here, so put a spacer. Size should be 45. Now put a blog layout. Come here and search for blog layout, and this is the one we want, so just paste it over here. Limit should be 8. We want 8 per page. Okay, now scroll down. Show pages, yes. Layout should be grid. Filter categories, grid columns 4. Masonry column number should be 4. Gutter is fine, 10. Okay, all this setting is fine. And in the class, just type in grid dash type dash one. Okay, and in the template select the type one. Okay, now click on update and preview this page. Okay guys, so we have successfully created the blog page. Now we have to create the about us page. So let's see how our about us page looks like. Okay, as you can see, this is how it looks like. So let's start creating our about us page. Let's cut this thing. Now come back to the dashboard again. How our pages, and select add new, and in the title type in about us. Now scroll down and we'll see some setting over here. Breadcrumbs and title, select show both breadcrumbs and title from here, and here select no padding. Then in the featured image you have to select the image you want to keep over here. So let's select that image. This is the image. Click on set featured image. Fine. Then at the top we should see an excerpt option. We are not seeing that. So what we can do is come over here, and here you'll see screen options, and under that tick mark the excerpt option. Now again scroll down. Now we have the excerpt option, and here you have to type anything which you want to display over here. So we have to type get to know us better. So just type that. And click on publish. Now click over here, MotoPress content editor. Fine. Now copy this thing. And over here, put in a paragraph. Paste it over here. Now duplicate this. Again, duplicate this one. Fine. So this is how you do it. You can create as many columns as you want. You can change the text from here. Now we have to set the column settings. So click over here, column setting, and type in 12 and 4. Rest everything will be fine. Again, this column setting, 12, 4, not 121, 12. Now cut this, and the last one, same setting, 12 and 4. Again, cut this thing. Now select the row setting. This should be fixed width, and both top and bottom padding should be 80. Okay, now cancel this. After that we have an image and again some text. So first let's copy this text. How over here, select WordPress text, scroll down, and now click on add media, upload the image. This is the image we want, and from here only you can select the size, which is full size. Fine. Now click on insert into page, click on save. Now again select paragraph, drag it over here till you see the column over here at the right side. Now paste the thing which we have copied. Fine. So we have done this, the image and the text over here. Let's add some space over here. So click on spacer. Okay. Type 70. And as you can see, there is some gap over this text, so let's do that also. Again, select spacer and now put it over here and type in 40. Fine. Now select this one, the row, and make sure the whole row is selected. Width type should be fixed width. And background type should be color or image, and from the styling present select gray. Rest everything is fine. And in style top and bottom padding should be 80 pixels. So do that. Now cancel this. Now select this first column setting. Okay, scroll up. Now do it 12 and 12. Now select the second column. And again 12 and 12. Cut this. Fine. Now we have to add this post over here, as you can see. So first let's update this page. Now we have to add this post. Okay, so hover here and click on posts, drag it to the bottom. Post per page should be 3. Post type will be posts. Fine. Okay, scroll down. Image size should be 475 into 300. Okay, and here type in 12 12 4 4. Now select the template from your post one, but here as you can see the type of post is different. The post type over here and the post type over here are different. So what you have to do is again go back to your dashboard, hover cherry, select shortcode template, and under post click on add new. Again go back to my website, click on that custom code file, and there you will see post template for about us page. So just select that code, copy it, select everything over here, delete it and paste it over here. Now click on save, and as you can see the name is posts 2, so we have to select this one. So for that again we have to update and refresh this page. Okay, now scroll down, click on here and scroll to the bottom, and in the template select post 2. Now as you can see it looks very much similar. So this was post 2. Now cut this thing. Now we have to add this section. Okay, before that let's add some spacer. So add some space between both the sections. Put it as 60. Cancel this. Now here we have some paragraph, so just copy it over here and from here drag the paragraph, make a new row, paste the paragraph over here. Fine. Now we have to add this progress bar, the charts. So for that first update this page, come back to your dashboard in the shortcode template, select the charts from here, click on add new. Again go back to that file, and at the top we have this shortcode template under chart. So just select this code, copy it, come over here, select everything, delete and paste the code over here. Now click on save. So we have done the chart template. Now we have to create different charts. As you can see we have 3 charts over here. So let's do that. Again come back to your dashboard, hover charts and click on add new chart. You can name anything. For example, you can name chart 1. The chart type should be progress bar. Progress bar type should be horizontal. Width should be 570. And the height should be 25. Triangle progress bar should be off. And chart 1 is already selected, which we have just created. Okay, now here in the setup chart data, first let's see, we have coffee cups 45%, so just over here instead of value type in coffee cups, in done type in 45, and in total it will be 100. Here it is blue color, so what you have to do, in item color 1 select blue, fine. Now chart stroke thickness, we want 0, we don't want any strokes. And in chart background color, we have to select hashtag and 6 times 3. Okay, after you do so, just click on publish. So we have successfully created the first chart. We have to create more 2 charts. Fine, so click on add new chart. Type in any title like chart 2 and make all the setting as same. This will be off 570 into 25. Chart template 1, fine. And the value for second will be projects done 65%. So in done, type in 65. The second color is green color. So under item number 1 color, select green. Fine. Background color, as I said, it will be hashtag and then 6 times 3. Strokes will be 0, so put 0 for strokes, and again click on publish. And then we have to create this third chart. Again click on add new chart, type any title like chart 3, all the settings will be same. Fine, this will be off. Now enter the value, happy customers, anything you want, 80, 85, whatever you want. Now the color is yellow, so select item 1 color and select yellow from here. Background color will be this. Strokes will be 0, stroke thickness will be 0, fine. Now click on publish. Now from here click on all charts, as you can see under charts, so click on all charts, open these charts in a new tab, all these 3 charts in 3 different tabs because we want their shortcodes. Now come back to your page, the about us page which we are creating, update this page and refresh the page. Now we have to add these charts over here, so scroll this WordPress text and make this new column. Fine, click on insert shortcode, search for chart, fine, and you have to enter the chart ID. So let's see the chart IDs, for example the chart 3, first let's see the chart 1, this is the chart 1, at the bottom you'll see this chart ID, it is 3649, so here put in 3649 and click on insert shortcode, and after that we have to add some space, as you can see over here. So again click on insert shortcode and search for spacer, and 30 will be fine. Click on insert shortcode. Now again copy both this thing, paste it over here, again paste it over here. Now only thing we have to do is change the chart IDs. Now the chart ID for chart 2 is 3650, so copy this and paste it over here, and chart ID for chart 3 is 3652, so again copy and paste, replace the chart ID over here. Now click on save. Okay, now let's click on preview. let's scroll down. Okay, fine. So we have to change the row setting now. So again, come back over here, click on row, make this as full width, and background type will be color or image. And in the styling present, select info, and in the style it should be padding top 80 and padding bottom should also be 80. Now cancel this. Now select this first column from here and type in 12 and 6. For the second column also, type in 12 and 6. Now again, let's preview. So as you can see, now it looks much better. So with this, we have also completed the About Us page. So make sure you update this page. Now let's create the Contact Us page. Let's see how a Contact Us page looks like. Okay, so this is how our Contact Us page looks like. Now what we have to do is create this page. So come back to your website and hover over here and click on page. So from here also we can create a new page. Now in the title, put in Contact Us and click on publish. Now in the left sidebar, you'll see something called contacts over here. So hover that and click on add new. And again, come back to this code page and here you'll see contact form. So just copy the code below the contact form till here. Fine. Come here, name anything like CF1, like contact form 1, and select everything from here, delete it and paste all the code from our page. Fine. Now click on save and copy this shortcode. This is a shortcode. Select over here, click on copy. Now select the cherry option and click on options. Now we have to enter the Google API code. So open a new tab, type in console.developers.google.com. In order to display a map on our website, we need an API key from Google. So make sure you create an API key. It's really simple. I have already created. So what you do is go to credentials over here. And here is the key, so I just copy this key and come here. Here you'll see Google Maps API key, paste it over here and after that click on save options. Okay, once you do so, again come back to the pages. Now select the Contact Us page and click on edit with MotoPress. Now hover over here and select Google Map, drag it over here, type in the address where you stay. For example, I'm typing in Sion, Mumbai. You can type in your own address. Map zoom level should be 10. Scroll wheel should be no. Map style should be Apple's Maps. Height should be 560. And the marker resource, just click on upload, and we have already uploaded this image. So select this image and put in this in the content. First it will be P inside arrow brackets, then your address one line, and suppose you want to leave another line, so you put in this code, then you put in the another line, and after that to end this everything you put in this code. Fine. After that, click on update. Here you have the column settings, the three dots, click on that. Scroll down. Here you have column collapse, column paddings. You have to select yes. Now cancel this. Now we have to put this thing over here. I have already taught you how to do this thing in the home page. We have done the same exact same thing. So I think I should not waste your time showing the exact same thing again. Let's do this one, the contact page. Fine. Come back to the motor press. How over here? Now drag the paragraph over here. Now copy this text. Paste it over here. Fine. Then we have some gap. Then again we need a spacer. Drag it to the bottom. Add 40 size spacer. Then again drag in the WordPress text, okay, to the end. For that you have to go to your dashboard, scroll down. Here you have the contact. Click on contact forms. This was the form we created, CF1. So here is the shortcode. Just click on here, click on copy and paste it over here. Now click on save. Now click on update. And now let's preview this page. Okay guys, so as you can see, now we can see the contact page. So this is how you create a contact page. So we have also created the contact page. Now the last page is remaining, the services page. So let's see how it looks like. So this is how our services page looks like. Now let's create this services page. So again, come back over here, hover new and click on page. In the title, put in services. Now click on publish. Now scroll down. And here you have to select show both breadcrumbs and titles. No padding. Now set a featured image. For example, in the services page, we have this featured image. So let's select this one. Here it is. Now scroll down. In the excerpt, you have to type in this. Whatever you want over there. We are typing we are good at. So once you do so, just click on publish. So we have created the services page. Now we have to create some services. So at the left sidebar, you'll see something called services over here. Hover that and click on add new. In the demo website, as you can see, we have 4 services. So now let's add 4 services and see. In the title, just you can type in anything like service 1. You can create a new category. For example, let's create a new category called default. Click on add new category. Now put in any text you want over here. I'm just pasting in some text. Now set a featured image. Now click on publish. Similarly, we have to create 3 more services. Okay, so after creating the services, we have to create a template for service. So again, hover cherry, click on shortcode templater, come back to that page, the code page, and here you see service template. So copy the code over here and from here click on service, click on add new. Select everything, delete it, paste our code and click on save. So the name is services1.template. Now let's also create the banner template because we have to create a template for this one. This is the banner. Okay, so again come back to the code page. Here is the code for banner template. Just copy this. Come back to the shortcode page. Click on banner. Click on add new. Select all this thing, delete it, paste in our code and click on save. Okay, once you do that, come back over here, click on pages. Now under services, click on edit with MotorPress. Now in our demo website, as you can see, first we have some text. So just copy this text from here and now drag this paragraph over here. Paste all the code over here. Okay, after that we have some gap, so let's put some space, drag the spacer over here, make the size as 40. Now after that we have these services which we have created, so again come back over here, however this, select services, here it is, fine. Drag it over here. Now the limit should be 4 because here we have 4 services as you can see, and image size should be 475 into 300, and in column classes you can put 12, then 6, then 3, then 3, and select the template which we have just created, the services 1 template. Fine, so as you can see now this looks very much familiar now. Now click on update, cut this, and after that we have a parallax image with some icons on it, so let's put that. Come back over here, hover text, select WordPress text, drag it over here, click on insert shortcode. Select icon from here. Here the icon is umbrella, so click on icon picker, search for umbrella, here it is, select this one, icon size should be 44, fine. You can select any icon color, let's select white because here we have white icon color and the background is this color, this particular color is the background, so you can select border and background color should be the same. As you can see the background color is something like orange and the icon color is white, so make sure icon color is white, background color is different, geometric type is round. After you do so, click on insert shortcode. Now after that I click on enter. Now click on insert shortcode, select this box, primary setting, in the background position select bottom center, rest everything is fine. Now click on insert shortcode. Now from here delete this present and this primary, fine. And BG position is equal to bottom center, so from here delete this bottom and dash, so it should be only center. Now delete this also, your content goes here, and instead of that content we have to type in this thing, so just copy and paste it over here. Also the text color is white, so what you do is select both this text. And over here is the text color, select this, click on white, so this becomes white. Now click on save. Fine, so this is how it looks like. We have two different columns, so what we do is click on duplicate. So another column is made, the same thing. Now click on update. Now let's change the background color for this. Click over here, row settings, fixed width, background type should be parallax image, select the image, This is the image we want, so click on set media. Now come back to style, and the top padding should be 100 and bottom padding should be 80. Fine, do that. Cut this thing. Now click on update and refresh the page so that we can see the background change over here. Now let's preview this page. Okay, as you can see, it looks beautiful. Now again, come back over here and here we can see the changes. Now select this first column and type in 12 and 6. Rest everything will be fine. Same for this column, 12 and 6. So similarly, you can create as many columns as you want. Okay, you can change the icon and color of these columns. Let me show you one example. For example, suppose you want to change the icon and color of this one. So double click over here. The icon over here is umbrella. So just delete this and type in gears instead of this. And you can also change the background color. Suppose you want to know the background color of this thing. So what you do is click over here, right click over here, and select inspect. When you do so, you get a background color option over here. So just copy this. Okay, come back and instead of this color, type in this one. So the background color will be changed. Now click on save. So as you can see, the icon, the background color, everything is changed. So similarly, you can create as many different icons as you want. Fine. Now let's create this banner. So for that, hover over here and you'll see something called banner. Just drag it over here. Scroll down. It asks for text color. Let's see, the text color is white. So what you have to do is select white from here. Drag it to the uppermost thing. Hashtag and 6xF is the code for white. Okay, now the background color. Let's see the background color. Again, click on inspect element. Here is the background color. So just copy this and come here, paste it over here. Fine. In the template, we have created a template, banner one, so select that. This looks cool. And in the content, as you can see, we have some text and a logo. So what we do is click on open in WordPress editor, delete this thing, and now we add this one. Click on insert shortcode and search for title box. Here it is. Now we have to copy the title and the subtitle. This is the title. This is the subtitle. Fine. The title color and the subtitle color, it's all white. So click over here, select white from here. Again, subtitle color, select white from here. Icon size should be 80 because we have an icon over here. So it should be 80. Fine. And from your icon picker, you can select any. For example, type in laptop. So this is the icon and this is the size of that icon. And subtitle will be first, so select this one. And we want a smaller size, so title size should be smaller, so select this one from here. Fine. Now click on insert shortcode. Now copy this thing over here. Copy it. Click on save. Now what you have to do is select this and click on duplicate. Again, click on duplicate. So we have three different columns as you can see. Now again, click on this, double click on this, Now we have to change the background color. So let's inspect this. Right click over here, select inspect. Then here we get the background color. You can change and keep any color you want, obviously. Now from here, change the background color. So as you can see, the background color is changing. Fine. We also have to change the text color, because as you can see over here, the text color over yellow is black. So what you have to do is change this color to black. So drag it to the bottom. Now copy this code, because we want to make this color, and click over here, open in editor. Now the title color, paste that same code. Subtitle color, paste the same code. Fine. Now click on save. Okay, this is looking cool. So similarly, you can change this color also. Click on inspect element. Here is the background color. Double click over here, change the background color. Fine. So this is how you do it. And we also have to change, as you can see, there is a lot of gap, and here we don't have any gap between the columns, so we have to do that setting. First, let's do column setting. Click on here, full width. Fine. Close this. Now select the first column, and here it should be 12 and 4. Now scroll down, and collapse column padding should be yes. Now cut this. Now select the second one. Here also it should be yes. Fine. Now come up, and here the size should be 12 and 4. Now select the third column. Here also the size should be 12 and 4. And coming down to the bottom, collapse column should be yes. Now click on update, and let's preview this page. Okay, so this looks exactly the same, and this is really amazing. So with this, we have also completed the services page. Now few things are left, for example the logo over here, the menu bar. So these things are left, so let's do that. Come back to your dashboard, hover appearances, and you'll see an option called menus. So select that menus. You can name anything. For example, we are naming main menu. Now click on create menu. Now here we have the pages, so select all the pages you want in the menu. I'm selecting almost all the pages we have. The services, contact us, about us, blog page and home page. Now click on add to menus. Now we can rearrange this. First we want the home page, so what you can do is drag it over here to the top. Then if you want, you can have this about us page. And similarly, whatever page you want, you can rearrange this. And make sure you tick mark this one, primary menu, so that the theme knows that this menu will be our primary menu. After you do so, click on save menu. Let's refresh the page, and we should see the menu over here. So as you can see, we can now see the menu over here. Now let's change the logo from here. So again, come back to your dashboard, click on cherry. And here you have the first option, favicon image. What is a favicon image? For example, here when you see the demo website, at the top you have this small logo, that is the favicon. In my website, at the top, if you see my cursor, there is a small logo, that is a favicon. Okay, so cancel this and upload your favicon. Choose media. This is the favicon we want, so select this, click on choose media. Okay, now click on save options. Options have been saved. Now from here, as you see, here you'll see the header option, then logo, then click on logo. Now again, cancel this, choose media, and now select your own logo. This is our logo. Now click on choose media. Okay, scroll down, click on save options. Fine. Now again, let's come back to our website and refresh and see the changes. So as you can see, now we can see the logo, our homepage. Now let's scroll down. Now let's create this footer, because we don't have the footer here, and here as you can see we have the footer. So now let's do that. For that, again come back to your dashboard, hover appearances and select widgets. Now here you'll see footer sidebar 1. So what you have to do, you have to select the text. Let's search for text, here it is. Now drag it in the footer sidebar 1. Okay, so it has come in the footer sidebar 1. And in the content, type in this image logo and cherry spacer. These are the short codes for image logo and cherry spacer. After that, you can type in anything, for example, like this. Just type in anything you want and click on save. Okay, now we have to enter the footer sidebar 2. So we have a menu in the footer sidebar 2. Fine. So we can search for menu. Custom menu. Here it is. Select this, drag it to the footer sidebar 2. In the title, you can type in custom menu and select the menu, the main menu which we have created. Again, click on save. Then the third one is recent post. So again, minimize this. Open the footer sidebar 3. Here is the recent post. Just drag it over here. You can, you know, put any title, for example, recent posts, number of post, and tick mark this, display post data, and click on save. Last one is Instagram widget. So minimize this, maximize the sidebar 4. And here we have cherry Instagram, just drag it to the footer sidebar 4. In the title, put in my Instagram, and you can select my photos, which photos to show, my photos or tagged photos. Okay, and username. Now click on save. Now again, let's come back to the website and see the changes. As you can see, guys, we can now see the changes over here. This is the first sidebar, second, third and fourth sidebar. And as you can see, this is something which we don't want, so we have to remove this. For this, again come back to your main page, the dashboard, and here select cherry, and when you scroll down we'll see something like style switcher. Just click on that, and here click on disabled. Fine, and click on save options. Now again, let's come back and refresh the page and see the changes. It should be gone. As you can see, now we can we cannot see that. Okay guys, so let's see our home page. Okay guys, so as you can see, when we click on our home page, we see some awkward, some different kind of page. So what you have to do is click on customize. Now click on static front page. Now select the static page, and in front page select the home page which we have created. So now home page has become the home page, the real home page. Now click on save and publish and cut this thing. But as you can see, there is a lot of gap over here. We don't want any gap. If you see the demo website which we have created, let's say this. As you can see, there is no gap, but in this website we are getting this gap. So what you can do is click on edit page. Now scroll down to the bottom, and here select no padding, and here no sidebar. Fine. In the layout, it will be no sidebar. In choose padding, it will be no paddings. And after doing so, just click on update. So if you face this problem, this spacing problem in any page, you can do the settings. Fine. Now let's again see the page and see the changes. Click on view page. Okay, the gapping has gone. Okay guys, so with this we have created our website and we have completed our tutorial. I hope you guys like this tutorial. If you guys like this tutorial, make sure you subscribe to my channel and give a thumbs up to my video. Thank you for watching.